perhaps the best way to go about it is to think about it's what has been my experience with a colonizing approach to psychology and practice in general. And I think that one of the things that I had a very strong reaction to when I was in my undergrad years is that what was very puzzling to me is that we were talking about folks' mental health and we were talking about interventions, and yet there was very little consideration around the context in which things were happening, particularly for those who are not from what we call the dominant or the mainstream voice in the room, right? And I had that experience because I was coming from Brazil, and you know, we were talking a lot about psychology and how our operational definitions were, and even those operational definitions would always have to fit a particular methodology that really stripped out all that was personal, all that was contextual, social, cultural. And I was always left wondering about what are we not talking about? So one of the things that really resonated with me was, and I couldn't really articulate it at that point, was that that there was more to the conversation than what was being, addressed in the room. And as I moved into my graduate studies, I was introduced to the concept of self. And that was probably, it sort of saved me, I guess, in a way, because I was very discontent with the very cognitive approach of psychology, of psychometrics for the sake of psychometrics, and then trying to create a story based on the psychometrics. And as I moved into my interests of looking at, is this just a theory, or is this something that actually happens when we are in the process of delivering services, when we are seeing our clients, or when folks are reaching out to really get support, is that something that is making it to the other end, right? And I often found that, that there was sort of a disconnect between a lot of the theoretical ideas about support and what was really happening.